Hello everyone and welcome to Sessions with Judith John. Hope all of you are keeping fine. In today's session, I will be speaking to you about letter writing. Letter writing, if you see, is an art by itself. And there are so many famous letters down history that have changed history, that have changed the lives of people. You must read some of those famous letters written by Gandhi, written by Jawaharlal Nehru to his daughter, written by Abraham Lincoln to his son's teacher. There are so many letters. If you can just Google out those famous letters, and you will be able to see so many of them, and you can also benefit from it. Now, if we go on to letter writing as per the CBSE syllabus, the letter writing question appears in part B as question number 3. The total marks awarded to this question is 5 for this academic year, and approximately the space that you can take to write one letter is 2 pages of your answer sheet. Remember always all the little tips that I keep giving you to score the complete marks for each of the questions here. It's start the letter on a new page. Never start it somewhere in between a page at all. If you look at the marking scheme, the format carries 1 mark. So you have to be so careful about the format, which I will be speaking to you about just now. And then the content, to the point content. No extra flamboyant things. Okay, and then of course our expression, the grammatical accuracy with which we write, the apt words used, okay, the spellings and the relevance of the ideas and style, all these also carry weightage. If we go on to the next, we can see the most common form of written communication is the letter. If you look at in our olden days, they did not have all these modern means of communication. It was only through letters that people could communicate easily, even if it be to their family, loved ones, or whether it be official, whatever. Communication means letter writing. Letters should have a format that goes with the latest conventions. Now, why have I mentioned here with the latest conventions? If you look at in the olden times, letters were handwritten. Now, when you handwrite letters, then they were writing the address in the top right corner, coming back to the left to write a letter, and again signing off with yours lovingly or whatever to the right hand side. It is a zigzag movement here and there. So now, with the coming of the computers, the letter writing has been made very simple with just you pressing an enter button each time and then just going on with keep to the left policy. So from beginning to the end of the letter, you can just start every other line with starting with the left hand side only by pressing enter, as most letters are typed on the computers. Okay, so in general, when we talk about letters, they are the informal and the formal. The informal ones are those letters which we write to our dear ones, our close, those who are close to us, our family, those whom we love and care for. These are letters which you would have started writing way back from your primary school onwards and carried on to the middle school. A number of letters to your uncle, aunt, your father, mother, brother, sisters, cousin, sisters, and so on. Or your friends. Now, that's why informal letters are also called friendly letters. Okay. So, because it's more casual. What we are going to focus here as per the syllabus is not the informal letters, but the formal letters. When we talk about formal letters include business or official letters. They can be for inquiring something, complaining, for asking and giving information, placing orders and sending replies to the same. Okay, or letters to the editor. I'm sure all of you would have seen the columns in the newspapers where the letters to the editor are published. whatever letters you write to the editor of a newspaper, it would be published, or to any magazine for that matter, even they are published, okay, or application for a job. Now these are essential letters in all of us, that all of us should know in life at some point or of time or the other. We are going to write letters pertaining to these. Approximately, now I told you the length can be 2 pages of your answer sheet, but when the question is asked in the question paper, they would mention 120 to 150 words. You may just ignore the counting of words, you don't have to do it. You just approximately go with the pages that you're using. As long as the matter is correct, the content is correct, and then no marks will be cut for that. So the total marks is 5 marks, which is already what I have told you. The proper layout has to be there with the sender's address, date, receiver's address, subject line, the salutation, subscription. All this together forms the format of the letter and carries 1 mark. And then you have the content, the relevant ideas to be presented in a very coherent way. I will be giving you more details as we go with this. Use connectors appropriately and divide into paragraphs. Each time you're shifting ideas or you're presenting more than one point, there should be minimum 1 paragraph and maximum 3 paragraphs, depending on the kind of letter that you are writing, which I will be speaking to you again a little more about this as we go ahead. And the expression, of course, I've already told you about this. And no marks will be given if you present only the format with no content at all. So just make sure that your content is written completely. Okay, we move on to the formal letter format. The formal letter format is something all of you should know so well, so thoroughly well. That's the reason I've highlighted here again to the right hand side. If you can see here again, I have put in a box to show how your letter should come out. So right here should be the sender's name and address. In maybe just 2 lines, make it very short, 2 or 3 lines maximum. And then you have the date to be written over here. And then the receiver's name and address. And then you have the line here for subject. The subject line has to be written in only 1 line. Never carry it to the second line. To use a maximum of only 5 or 6 words that will fit within this 1 line. And then you have the salutation, respected so and so, honored people do right, or just dear sir or madam. And then you have the content. The content there I have given you 3 lines. You can go on extending as and how depending on the content. Introduction, body and conclusion doesn't fit into all letters. It is only content in 1 paragraph at most times in official letters. And then you have thank you and yours sincerely, yours faithfully, or yours truly in an official letter or a business letter, and then with your signature. So this is, you know, just to show you how a letter should be presented. Now I would like to go to some nuances over here. First of all, the date, which should be written in a month with the month in words. Okay, then you have the receiver's address. Again here the designation is important. If you're writing an official letter, if it is a supposing the manager of a bank, then you have to write the manager, okay, and the name of the bank. Or if you're writing to your principal, the school principal, the principal, and then below that the name of the school. So this is something very, very important and you have to keep in mind. The subject line, I repeat, it has to be in 1 line only with 5 to 6 words and not more than that. And then you have your one more important thing, the word thank you. Many people write thanking you. Now thanking you is a continuous tense. You need not continue thanking that person for how long will you. So just complete it with a crisp thank you. All right, and that's understood. We be crisp and short and sweet. Then you have the subscription, which is very important. Here you cannot write anything else. You write either yours truly, yours sincerely, or yours faithfully for official letters. Okay. Now, what are the different points that you have to remember more than what I had shown you just now in the format, that all that I spoke was for format? Here we have to use formal and polite language. Even in my earlier videos, you would have seen I insist on this. English is a language of the elite. Please try to use only formal and polite language in writing, especially official letters. You have to be very clear and specific, brief and to the point, using short sentences. Do not use very long sentences. By the time the person reads and comprehends, it will be difficult for them. So try to make short, crisp sentences. Okay. The decorum of the language has to be maintained. Even if you are writing the letter of complaint, ensure that your language is polite. You don't have to show your anger. You don't have to use hurting words. Okay, while writing letters to the editor, do not ask the editor to solve the problems. He is not sitting there to solve all your problems. He is there to sit and edit your letters and make sure that they are published in his newspaper or in his magazine so that the awareness is created, many others look at it, and the concerned authorities will also have access to your letter. But he is not the one, he is not God, he is not sitting there to solve issues. So please do not do that. Marks are not awarded if format is given. This is something I have already said. So do not leave an incomplete letter with just a format. Now in job applications, ensure that you have a separate resume attached to your letter. Do not mix up the resume within your letter. All right. So this is one more important point that you have to remember. And then we move on to see in, particularly letters to the editor. Letters to the editor usually contain giving suggestions on issues of public interest, expressing views on an issue already raised in an article that you have seen in the paper and you want to voice your opinion, okay, which has been published in the paper already, or any social issue or concern of the public or a sector of people or the people living in your area are facing a problem and you want the authorities' attention to be drawn to it, then you can take two pages, because by the time you write the, to and from and date and subject line, almost 3/4 of the page is gone. So when you have to actually discuss the points, you need some space. So you can take two pages for that. And this has to be written in 2 or 3 paragraphs, because in the first paragraph, you will be raising the issue or the problem. You will be offering suggestions or giving solutions in the next paragraph, and conclude requesting the editor to publish it so that the problem will be resolved. Usually, you sign with a subscription of yours truly over here. Now, we can see some of the sample letters that are being published in the paper. You may think, why is the format not there? Now, when they publish your letter in the paper, they may, for the sake of saving space and publishing many other people's letters, they may go down straight to the issue itself, and they will not give you the complete format of the letter as you have written. You can look up the newspapers for later ones, examples, to see more of it. Okay. Now, coming to making inquiries, asking for information, replying to inquiries or giving information or making a request or appeal, these letters are very short. The content is just in 8 lines or just 1 paragraph. Then you don't have to extend and make extra paragraph. Come straight to your what matter you want to inquire about. Make a proper list of the relevant questions in a sequence, in an order. Put it very nicely, politely. Be very brief and to the point. This is very important in these letters. Okay. Now, coming to registering complaints, this is something very special. Why? Because you should know how to complain. When complaining about a product purchased, you have to include the date of purchase, product name or the model number. Mention that photocopy of the bill is also attached for their reference. Mention if it's within the warranty period. Mention if you are seeking a refund or replace or repair, whatever is the need according to you. Then when you are registering a complaint of services, mention the complaint and ask very politely to attend to it. You don't have to be rude and use rude language. Now, when we are talking about placing orders and sending replies or cancelling anything to do with ordering, usually we write placing orders only for very bulk orders. It's not done by for a single order or something, unless it is something a very expensive product that you are placing an order for. State whether you are a regular customer, and if so, do ask for a discount. Even otherwise, you can mention the mode of payment. This is something very important these days when we are paying online, and make sure that the following table given here, as I have given here, is added to your letter, because you have to be clear what product you require, what's the quantity that you require, which brand, and the quoted price, and from there you're asking for a discount. While replying, make sure that you add the acknowledgement, the fact that he is your regular customer. Mention what discount offers you will be giving him. Add another column to the same table which he has already sent by giving your final price, so that the person knows whether to go ahead with the purchase. Coming to letters of job application. Now, application for a job again is something, see, all these letters, official letters, at some point of time, all of us will need to know how to write. So here we are talking about letters of job application. In these letters, it's a must to write in the subject line, application for the post of. Which post are you applying for? Okay. The content should be just in 5 to 6 lines as shown here. Now, this is one sample I've provided with reference to your advertisement in the Dash newspaper dated on this date. I find myself eligible to apply for the post of this. Please find attached or enclosed my resume or CV. And make sure that the letter starts on a new page and your resume on the next new page. Okay, so this is how your resume should go. There are some essential points that must be present. This is the complete format I've given you here. You may add in somewhere I've given, as I'll tell you, optional ones. For example, name must. Date of birth and age is a must. Father's name is a must. Current address, contact number, email address is a must. Educational qualification, I'll show you in the next slide what kind of a table you have to make, because this is something very important. Okay, because without knowing what educational qualification you have, no one's going to give you that job. The work experience, please put in only a maximum of 5 years, and in any kind of a small firm which is not here, please note something, never use names of well-established organizations at all. Like how you should not be disclosing your own name or your own school's name or your own, any of your personal details here. All right. So other skills, languages known, achievements, hobbies, all these can be added. These are optional ones depending on the kind of job. For example, when you say languages known to a receptionist, 3 or 4 languages is good enough. So you require that, but you need not require that for a mechanical engineer. So if you look up marital status, safe to write on a single always, or unmarried and leave it at that. Personal details. You must mention your health is good, height and weight. On an average, most jobs they require to find out whether you are healthy and fit. So this is a general say on, yes, I'm fine, I'm fit enough to work. Okay, and salary expected, you can always write negotiable, because later when it comes to the interview, you can speak about it in detail. References, if you have of any, the last college you attended, the principal of that college, the HOD from there, or your previous boss. All these have to be added in your resume. Now, coming to the table which I said about educational qualification, you have to give a very clear and precise, be precise in the details that you're providing. So here it is, you put the serial number. Now, if you observe the next column, the name of the exam, I have put in descending order, the last exam that you have completed should be the first on top. So it's like first you start with 10th, which is the basic requirement board exam marks for any higher studies. Okay, so start from there, and then you have your 12th, your bachelor's degree and your master's if you have any professional degree, add in that. So the latest should be the first one and go in reverse order. Next, the next column is board or university from where you have done it, the year of passing percentage. You can add one more column to this, the college or the school that you where you have studied. If it is a prestigious one and has a very good name, then it carries weightage. So keeping all these points in mind, as always I tell you, practice makes you perfect. There's nothing like written practice that you should go ahead with. So here I've tried to give one question at least on each of the kind of letters that I've been speaking about. Complaint and editor is here. You have some more inquiry and informing about the loss of your suitcase. Then you have you're placing orders and of course applying for a job. So please do practice writing all these questions. Having followed all the tips that I have provided here, hope that you will be able to score full 5 marks after going through this video, and all the best for that. Do keep watching Sessions with Judith John for more tips and inputs to excel in English. Text your doubts and queries in the comment box or mail me at Sessions with Judith John for online tutorials. You can also contact me for doubt clearing sessions only as per your requirement. So wish you all the best. God bless you.